Now, dear student, today I am going to show you how to print the square of all the numbers that are present. That see here I have given some number. You can change those numbers also. There is no any hard and fast rules that you have to give this number only. Then variable, we need to take one variable where we will store the square value, isn't it? Like here I have taken the sq. You can give any name. Name, taking a variable is not any type of hard and fast rule is there. Yes, one rule is there. The variable name should not be any keywords or any type of function name. Okay, it should not be that. Any type of restricted words or any type of keywords or any type of function name, it should not be. Okay, then after taking it, what I have done here is iterations. Iterations means repeating that process and finding out the executions of it. So what has been done for val in number? So calculate the square of each number. Square, let us open the program now so you can understand it. Okay. So you can understand it, that particular program syntax. This is the program, is it? This is the program where I have taken the numbers and I have taken every line. I have given a comment so that you can understand what the next line is working for. Okay, this is what a list of integers, as the comment has been given, a list of integers. After the list of integers, what is there? That variable to store in square of each number temporarily. For this is we have taken sq equals to 0. You can take any variable, but variable should be specified. It should not be any type of keywords or any type of functions. That is the important thing. So better you give those names related to the program only. Okay, don't think about any name which does not relate to the program. It will be make confusion to you. Because here you are writing a small program, afterwards you have to write a big program. So there your name doesn't tell it, the thing will not going to give you a proper output. Because though your question is right, your pattern of solving is also right, but the main things is not there. Okay, now how to do it, what you are going to find it, see here, that in this particular section, see here. First, it will take 1 square means 1, then 2 square means 4, then 4 square is 16, 16 square is 32, 36, and then 11 square is 121, and 20 square is 400. So, how it is doing it? It is taking the value val in number. Okay. So, another variable I am taking here, that is known as val, val in where? Number. Here, so after that, what has been done? SQ equals to val into val. So val in number means what number? That the number series of list what you have taken. That means I have taken here in the program. So this the particular thing, what the number is there, then I need to print it. Okay, so I need to print it. As I am printing it, the particular print options is there. And in this print option, what happens? It is taking the value and it is printing the value. As soon as it doing the work, val into val means 1 into 1, 4 into 4, 2 into 2, 8 into 8, 3 into 2. That means whatever the number you will going to give it, those the number will be multiplied with it. So you can, from here, you can find out here the square. You can find out the cube also, isn't it? So those the things that you can find out and you can implement it. Okay, so this is how you use this particular structure and you make this particular structures is that square of a number that is given in a list. Clear? So this is how you can do this particular program. This is how you can make this particular program and you can act with this particular program. Okay, so this is the things, this is the particular part that has been implemented here. SQ equals to val into val and print SQ. So this is the section, this is the part where we are working with, where I am finding that number square based on the number that has been given. You can change those variables. Again, I am saying you can change those variables. You can take a different list. So this is a pattern of one thing, you remember it.